So there you are. We are parents, both Rochelle and I, and we, you know, we have our views about children, and we go through different ages and stages mm-hmm. with your children. And older parents often say their children bring them joy and happiness, but in reality, they can also bring financial worry, stress, and anxiety.
Yes. However, new research suggests children do actually make people happier, but only once they've flown the nest.
Wow. Can you imagine that day?
Well, mine are 6 and 2, so to think of that is terrifying. But I do think my mum's probably a lot happier now. She's not got me around.
No, see, no, I didn't welcome that day. But would you ever admit that you were happier? So I definitely wasn't happier without my children being around. But we've got Lidge Hodgkinson here. She definitely said she did become much happier for many, many reasons, alongside Vanessa Feltz, who... You didn't. You weren't so happy. You weren't happy to see your children leave the nest.
Still haven't got over it. I can't stand it. My ideal template for life would be, do you remember when we used to watch Dallas and the Ewing family?
Yes.
And they all lived at South Fork together? I'd like that.
All at each other's throats.
Oh, wait, no, not really. I mean, I always thought, what's the point? One daughter making soup at her house, another daughter making soup at her house, and me making soup for Ben at our house. Why don't I just make the soup? We're all living together. We all eat it. We all share it and we have fun.
That's the way it used to be, sort of pre-war, maybe post-war. As well,
isn't the beauty being close enough to want that? So you know, everyone come to my house tonight, but everyone can just go back to their own little lives. Isn't that quite nice?
You wait till your girls fall in love, and that white knight comes in on the steed and whisks them off and marries them and takes them away from you. Oh my God, it was agony. There I was paying for the wedding, and then suddenly it's bye, and you're like, hang on, wait.
Yeah, what about me?
And I kept saying to my son-in-law, okay, you've had the honeymoon now. You know, you've had the wedding. Just leave her at home with
Liz,
us.
Liz, tell us about the joy that flowed into your life when your children left.
I was absolutely delighted when they left. absolutely delighted. I mean, they were so big and answering back and, you know, we were getting on each other's nerves and it was just time. It was just time for each of us to live our independent lives.
Children that are pre-adolescent, pubescent, are delightful. Then they go through all
Up to a point. But when they're 18,
it gets horrible.
My older son's 51 now, so he's long gone. I'm so old, even my grandchildren have flown the nest. But yes, I was absolutely delighted. It was time for us to lead our own lives and not cling on, not be at each other's throats. So I completely agree with that survey.
So what freedom did it give you? What was the difference? Like that your fridge was fully stocked, for instance?
That was one thing, but it was more than that because it was a complete life change for me. As soon as Will, my younger son, left, I separated from my then husband, sold the house, bought my own flat, and lived on my own.
I guess a bit of a reinvention.
Reinvention.
You know, not having to be relied on.
I have to say that we do have a fantastic relationship. I have a fantastic relationship with now my middle-aged sons. There's no emotional blackmail. There's no clinging on. I don't even give them a second thought.
See, it's funny Liz uses that word, clinging.
Yes.
You don't see that. You don't use the same terms or see it in the same way.
I don't think of it in the same way. I mean, I can only say it as I've lived it. And I really love hanging out with my girls. And actually, they both married two very nice blokes. I like them as well. Amazing. Ben gets on with all of them. My grandkids, obviously, an adornment, a joy, an absolute flipping beacon unto the nations. Who would I rather be with in the world? I love you all. Yeah. But would I rather spend time with my own kids and my own grandkids?
Vanessa,
of course I would.
Last night, I had the most joyous evening last night. I went to the cinema last night to see a film that Mrs. Holmes wouldn't be interested in.
Yeah.
And I persuaded my 26-year-old son to go with me. Mm-hmm. And I was absolutely, it was the most delightful thing. We went to the cinema, we had a meal afterwards. And see, to me, I don't know, I'm like you, just that bond. And maybe it's because sometimes with my kids, there's this stretch of water between Britain and Ireland that you sort of think if that wasn't there, you would be so much closer together all the time.
Well, absolutely. I thank God or whoever it is every day of my life that my kids live within very fast commuting distance. And you know, I love my friends, I love my job, but my family, you know, that's the absolute heart and soul. And if I could have afforded somewhere big enough for us all to obviously have a bit of independence but all live together, that would be my joy.
But really, you've got it in a sort of idyllic situation at the minute because, like you say, you adore your children and they've got husbands, X, Y, Z. If for, you know, heaven forbid, if for some reason their situations didn't work out and they were like, Mum, I'm back at home now... Mm. How do you think you'd actually feel about that?
I would bake some chicken soup. I would make a pie. Yeah. I would redecorate the bedroom. I'd be putting out the red carpet.
She's a party.
Yes. I'd be thrilled. Not that their lives discombobulated,
so
but
these,
any closer,
these
I'd
German
love it.
Researchers, yeah. They say they can actually prove that you as an adult will be happier or tend to be happier and healthier if your children are out of the house once they leave. And you
well, I would totally agree with that. I wanted to reclaim my own life and I just didn't want these six-foot giants in the same house anymore. I mean, you know, we get on very well, but we don't exert any emotional pull on each other. I mean, I'm not one of those parents who says, you know, I should be so upset if you don't come for Christmas. For instance,
right.
I don't you put sound any. Great company, <you do. laughs>
I don't put any expectations or anything on.
You like your own company.
Yeah. I like my own company. We get on extremely well. I'm having lunch with one of the families on Sunday. This will be the first time I've seen them since Christmas.
We should get on very well.
Really and get
all it's late August. It's the first time you've seen them since Christmas.
That's right.
I'm dying.
My mum would. Yeah.
I would be sending photographs of myself sobbing, weeping. Doctors' reports. Your mother's missing. Where are you? Emotional pull, come on. Absolutely not.
Jean says, when the kids leave home to start their new adventure, it means that your job is well done. That's exactly how it's meant
to
be.
It's over.
But then in time, you get lovely grandchildren, you can start all over again.
Well,
Kerry says, my daughter is 21 and buying her own home soon with her partner. It will break my heart when she moves out.
You sit in their room and sob. I mean, you sit in their empty room. And also, it's all so neat. It's all so quiet. The fridge is full, but you don't care. You haven't got the heart to eat it.
Oh, no, that's lovely. My kitchen is just for show. It's not for
food. Liz, you are some woman. You are some woman. Lovely to hear you. But, you know, by and large, I agree. I agree with Vanessa that getting family together is the happiest time. It's about laughter. It's about love. And the odd fighting.
Of course, an argument.
But that just comes with it. It's not Christmas without a little bit of a...
So, thank you guys. Thank you. Thank you.